Hello, this is a lecture on Russian grammar, Russian spelling difficulties. We can have difficulties, and the name of the topic is alteration of the vowel in the root of a word, and I'm going to speak about it. I also will post under my video, you know, the written explanations if I mishear something speaking. Let's look at first at the second pair of words. Позагорай, загар. Позагорай на солнце. Go and have suntan, have some tan in the sun. It's imperative mood. As we see, the root here is gor. In the second word, zagar, these are two derivatives of the same root. However, we see that the spelling in the root is changing. O alternates and becomes a in the second word. The second word is zagar. And I have here an example sentence. Zagar может быть красивым, а может быть и вредным. Suntan may be beautiful and may be harmful. So we see here a pair of these roots which can alternate gor, gar. There are a few of them in Russian. You have to go, to Russian grammar sites and look at all of them and look at examples, as many as you can find. These can be difficult for Russian people, for Russian speakers, not only for students who study Russian. For example, I was writing a story recently and I automatically made a mistake, and I noticed that mistake only on, only on third or fifth time, which I was reading my own story. You know, there was exactly this загорать, to suntan. And I was surprised that I missed that, So it happens. This is an important topic. Here I put in the middle orange color the classical ending of Russian infinitive, ч, т, мягкий знак, ч, and the verb. We can make the verb позагорать, загорать, загорать. The verb will have загорать, о. Spelling will be о. Загар, as we see, spelling is а, and the stress falls on а. So this is clear because the stress falls, загар. And sometimes in grammar explanation you will see that the roots with a stress are а, and without stress are о. I don't like that rule very much because it's obvious. When it is stressed, it's obvious what you spell. When it's not stressed, it's not obvious. But there is such explanation too. Rather, we have to just remember those roots and have a few examples and know how to write them. And the second pair of words here on the top of the slide. If you look at the blue color твор, отвори, in the words отвори, blue color твор, then it is also the part of the grammar which I started my explanation with. Твор, твар. However, here I show you different thing. So be aware that горгар is one of those alternating roots and твор, твар is the other alternating pair of alternating roots of Russian language which you have to go online and, have examples of them. But here I have a little bit catch. I always like to have some kind of catches, because I don't show you твор, твар here, the alternating roots. But I show you the other one, the other word, which would look like отвори картошку. Отвори means boil potatoes. Okay, so this is completely different meaning. However, if you look at them too. And that's why I put the твор blue color and отвори I put вар, because over there the root is вар, okay? So this is a little catch. So Tvor Tvar, I'm not giving here examples. I'm just saying that Tvor, blue color, exists. Tvar, this is a pair, belongs to the same grammar which I started explanation with, or alternative roots. But here I have different words which may look like belonging to that root, but however you have to know the vocabulary. This is kind of basic vocabulary. Varit, varit. Again, we can put this very handy here. Orange color, ending of infinitive, and in the blue. Blue color root, the word отвори, if you put this ending, we have отворить. Отворить means to open. And in this case, we have here the example phrase отвори калитку. Отвори калитку. Отвори, open the little gate. Калитка is a little gate. It looks like diminutive калитка, however, it is not. It is by nature diminutive. It doesn't exist. We cannot make regular noun of this. This is already diminutive, okay? This one. Калитка. Калитка is a little gate. Because big gate will be ворота, will be different word completely, okay? So here, you see, you can benefit from this lecture, a few things you learn. So, отвори калитку will be твор, твар, belonging to that grammar, okay? Твор, твар, you have a search for more examples. The scope of this lecture doesn't allow me to do everything what I want here, the timing. And the first word, отвори, the first word here on the top is отвори картошку. Отварить is to boil kind of in fast manner or in measured manner. Отварить means to start boiling and finish, okay? So this will be, as we see, варить. Is to boil, regular verb, варить. But отварить has от prefix. And I'm repeating you a simple knowledge of Russian grammar, that of Russian verbs, that prefixes, they give special meaning. So this prefix, it's perfective, makes the verb варить, boil, perfective, отварить, and it makes it kind of like certain boiling assignment. You know, отвори картошку, картошка варится, the potatoes boils from 5 to, you know, to 12 minutes, okay? It depends how you, if you boil small pieces, it will boil very fast. If you go big, huge potato, it will boil much longer. Okay, so отвори is just, you know, I ask somebody, you know, in the kitchen, отвори. You know, please boil, make this potato ready, boiled. Okay, so отварить is a nice verb to know in the kitchen. Okay, and the root here with картошка, with potatoes, картофель. By the way, we Russians borrowed this from German, obviously, картофель. Because our Tsar, Peter the Great, loved, you know, Germany and, you know, history connected with that. So, варить is different root, okay, варить, отвори картошку. Thank you, I hope this little lecture was helpful for listeners, and here I touched a few things in it, not only alternative roots of Russian which can confuse your spelling, which you have studied by heart, those pairs. Thank you. Goodbye.